Hello and welcome to our second tutorial of working with the AdventureWorks database. Today we're going to be looking at the select statement and how to use the select statement, how to pull data back from the AdventureWorks database. So go ahead and get logged into SQL. And the first thing we're going to do here is we want to expand the AdventureWorks database, and then we want to expand our tables. And then let's look at the persons table. So let's go ahead and expand that. So this is the actual table right here, and then this is the columns that are inside of that table. And these columns are going to be the ones that actually have the data. So there's two ways to perform a select statement. So let's go over the most simplest way. So simply select your table, and then we're going to right click, and then we just want to say select the top 1,000 rows. And it'll automatically generate this statement for us, or this query. And what a query means, it means instructions. So what we're doing is we're giving machine instructions to perform this task. So let's go ahead and take a look here and see what's going on, just real briefly. So we should have 1,000 rows. So here's 1,000, meaning our results over here. And then the address ID says 1,000. So why do these two match? Well, we'll get into IDs more later on, but just note that this is the address ID. Think of that as the records, and when I say record, I mean this. All of this is considered a record. Think of that like the records identifier, or like the value, or something that you use to identify that specific record. And you'll use that later on to select specifically this record for modifying it or whatever that is that you want to do with it. But just know that we'll talk about that later on, and that's more of a structure type thing. So if we come up here, then we take a look of what's going on here. Some first things we want to look at is these two keywords, select and top. So select says select something, and then top says I only want the top, and then followed by the value, in this case 1,000. So we could extend that to say we want 10,000, 5,000, whatever. In fact, let's go ahead and say we just want the top 100, so you can see how that works. So go ahead and switch that to the top 100. And now instead of having the 1,000 results, now we only have 100 results. And then we could also just say select top one, and then we only get one. So this is the last result that was put in. So it's the top result. Now, another thing to look at is the from statement. The from keyword is saying we want it from the AdventureWorks database, and then we want this table. You can see right here, this table is named person.address, and therefore this is named person.address right here. Now, there's an easier way to do this. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new query, and then I'm going to strictly be working in the AdventureWorks database. That's all I'm going to be doing. So what I can do here is I can just say I want only the AdventureWorks database, and then I'm going to say select, and then I want to pull back the city. I just want the city. And that's going to be from the person dot address. Now, I'm going to go ahead and run this statement, and then we'll go back over why this is in blue. So this gives me all the cities listed, and we'll see how many actual listings there are. There's 19,614 records total. Now, that doesn't mean that all these cities listed are unique, because you're going to see like some of these are going to be showing up multiple times, like Berlin, for example. We'll talk about later on, we'll talk about distinct. But for now, let's just focus on the basic fundamental of select itself. So we're just simply selecting all the cities in this table. Now, address is a keyword, just like select is a keyword and from is a keyword. These tell it to perform a specific type of function or to do something specifically. So what you can do, number one, is never name something using a keyword. That's just bad practice. But I didn't create this database. So when that happens, though, what you can do is you can put it in a bracket. You could put everything actually in brackets if you want. In fact, it's actually a pretty good practice to put things in brackets. So it looks like this. This will do the exact same thing. So if we execute, we get the exact same results. And this time we don't have the keywords, outlined in blue because it knows that I'm not using this as a function. I'm not using address as a function or as the keyword itself or whatever it's supposed to do. I'm simply saying look for this within the database. And that's all it's doing. Now, we can do some other things though with our select statement though too. We can select data from other tables and combine them into this. We'll talk about that later on. That's called joins. That gets into inner joins, outer joins, and so on and so forth. So looking at this though, what happens if I want to select more than one column in my database? So what if I want the address and the city? So what I can do here is I'm just going to drag and drop, or you can type it in however you want to do it. So because I have more than one, I have to put in a comma at the end of each column that I want selected until I get down to the end. So it's basically it's making a statement. And that's technically what this is just a statement saying select the address line 1 and select the city. I actually want the address line 2 as well. So it's going to look like this. So I want the computer to select address line 1 and address line 2 and the city. That's all I want. I'm going to execute. And now we have all this data. Now, I don't have brackets around these, but you can actually add the brackets if you'd like. And I can tell you that most DBAs will tell you to add the brackets just for formatting purposes. But it's really up to you on your personal preference. As a developer, because I am not a DBA, I often don't use the brackets. It depends on the application that I'm building. Sometimes I use them and sometimes I don't. In my stored procedures, which we'll talk about later, I almost always use brackets, but when I'm just simply doing a generic query like this to get data, I probably won't use a bracket. Right, and that concludes this tutorial on the select statement. In the next tutorial, we'll talk about some more in-depth type of select statements.